I detach from my identity, speaking unspoken language. A head full of broken dreams is all that I came with. My DNA map sit into actions with the ancients. I unravel space and time, uniting meditation and patience. The chambers in my mind are filled with quartz called designs. I've had lucid dreams, interacting with beings I can never describe. I thumb through pages of books written before they say God made us. Before the burst of song, the dawn, the Bronze Age. It was just dust and love that was blowing in the four winds. It was just us because we didn't care about where we'd been. Before the aurora lights had a chance to magnetize our skin. Before and after this time and space dimension. How do you trace with a pen that awaits beyond comprehension? What you feel now, that's what we're all commonly sensing. And that is this message, that is the best thing. We all need lessons on what it means to be a human being. I'm an angel spirit confused by ego and physical mortality, adding alcohol to my bloodstream. I stare off this balcony, I pollinate plants unknowingly, unwittingly spit lyrics into infinity. Only reason I walk alone, so nothing can inhibit me. And I escape to bring you back this imagery, this beating you all my Calgary. We were never meant to just sit and wait for heaven, so I built a gate for you and others to enter your dreams. Please step in.
For essentially exploring our own consciousness. This is a grotesque abuse of human rights. It's a fundamental wrong. If I as an adult am not, you know, sovereign over my own consciousness, then I'm absolutely not sovereign over anything. I can't claim any kind of freedom at all.
I got more love to give than just a little bit. When I write, I enter zones. My pen ignites explosive for my emotions to burst in the poems. Souls of a dying of thirst, we're living by the ocean. We came together in this moment to be awoken. Few thoughts woven, it happens first in the mind, but sustained through time. The heart must also be opened. Make one change in your life today. And I promise 1 year from now, you will never be the same. When you tap into the frequency of love so frequently, you won't ever get enough and you want to go back repeatedly. Whether through the practice of meditation or psychedelic drugs, there's the anticipation of a new world that awaits for us. Turn off the TV. Tomorrow is not promised. Literally, our time on this earth is like a passing comet. Feel the joy, feel the void, and you can't just make the world your reflection. Honor your childhood promise.
The vast masses of populations have been kept in a state of somnambulance, a kind of waking sleep.
Right.
You know, the Romans called it bread and circuses. You know, as long as you give the masses bread and entertain them with circuses, you can utterly control them in any way. Just keep them.
The answer is slowing the march and knowing that we're punching the clock to afford our own coffins, whether we like this or not. The other morning, I tried to convince my daughters money wasn't that important as I left for the whole day to support them, rewarded by the honorable harvest. Reciprocity, the generosity to be learned from the plants that do support us. Money doesn't just reward us, it even tortures the poorest. We are souls warring in cynical thoughts, ignoring the mystical gods. The problem-solving state of consciousness cannot solve this. Science can't quite quantify the truth we will see when we die. Explain the mind state an artist attains when he paints the sky. Tap into the joyful fractals that you released long ago while on the beach building sandcastles. Be wary of symbolic decoys, coiled snakes sent to destroy the sacred fire that burns within.
A lot of closets, man. There's
exactly.
Not just the gay closet.
Right.
There's all kinds of closets. There's the artist closet. Some people are fucking accountants. They're wearing suits and their ties on tight, and they're fucking like organized and disciplined. But inside, they're probably painters. They probably want to fucking paint. They want to paint day glow mountains down at the beach. That's what they really are. But their daddy or their mommy wanted them to be a good little businessman, so they became this thing that's the opposite of what they are. This is the verse in the Bhagavad Gita. God forgive me because I've quoted it way too many times, but it's better to be an honest street sweeper than a dishonest